Good morning, YouTubers. Today we have something that's rather special. This is downright scarce and might even call it rare. This is a Montgomery Ward's Airline AM radio and 45 RPM player combination built in 1951. These are kind of scarce for a couple of good reasons. Airline was the proprietary name for Montgomery Ward's, much like Silvertone was for Sears and Roebuck, and not a whole lot were made. It's a licensed RCA player because it features an RP168 mechanism inside, and as we well know, Montgomery Ward's and Sears didn't build things for themselves, so this was built by a third party for them. And it's a rather heavy radio slash 45 player, and the reason you don't see many is A, it was expensive, B, it was being sold by Montgomery Ward's, which wasn't quite as popular as Sears was back in its day, and C, being made of Bakelite, they were easily transferred around and broken along the way. In fact, this one has a very minor hairline crack in here that you can see. And this is a model 94BR-2008A. And up top here we have the AM tuning. This is your volume control. This is for the player slash radio. And this is the tuning for the AM band. And inside we have the RP168 45 player. So we're going to throw a couple of records on here, and mind you, this is going to be not for the content but just for demonstration. And notice that along the side here we have an on-off control, and we also have the reject. So let's give it a quick reject here. I'm going to let this reject, and then I'm going to shut the turntable off. As I said, we have a switch for that. So let me switch that off here and just move this on over. And give me 1 second here. I'm going to take and remove the records here so you can see what it looks like without the records in there. Nice and clean. Typical RP168. Again, this is an early RP168. Licensed by RCA, of course. Shelves are the rotary style, they're not the push-pull type, and there is no damper in this either. Now the radio, which we're going to go to right here now. Remember, this is a push button, and actually it's illuminated by a number 47 light bulb on the back side. You can't see it during the day, but
we're still going, and you know, we start
where are you
start,
from?
I'm from the Boston area.
Oh, okay. Hey, new
so
was,
let's
was,
tune was, it was, remember it's daytime.
More than likely. Now we've got to keep in mind that we have an
89-99 al mes por.
To sear in the natural flavors and juices. Cook's Perfect Meatballs deliver homemade taste in just minutes, making them the easy answer.
Whether your goals are growing your assets, preparing.
They were management hires. They weren't Bobby V.
You was sweet. I ain't mad at me, but the thing that twists me up about Mitty City taking out Big Bird.
Well, anyhow, there you go. This is another fine piece of 50s history. Rather scarce. In fact, I'm going to consider this one downright rare. These rarely show up. The last time I saw one was probably around 3 years ago, and it was beat, and the case was cracked all over the place. This one has a very minor crack here in the front. It's just going to happen with these things because they're very heavy and they got banged around, plain and simple. So there you go, another piece of 50s history. I hope you really enjoyed this. It's something different, something you rarely get to see. Have a great day now.